1. Rombotts et al., 2003. The major advantage of phylogenetic footprinting over the single genome is that multi-gene approach requires data of co-regulated genes. While phylogenetic footprinting can identify regulatory elements present in single gene, that remain conserved during the course of divergence of two species under investigation. With steep increase in available complete genome sequences, across-species comparisons for a wide variety of organisms has become possible. Blanchett and Tampa, 2002, Das and Dai, 2007. A multiple sequence alignment algorithm suited for phylogenetic footprinting should be able to identify small, 5 to 15 BP, sequence in a background of highly diverse sequences. Identification of new regulatory elements, L19, in legumin gene promoters by phylogenetic footprinting. In phylogenetic footprinting, primary aim is to construct global multiple alignment of the orthologous promoter sequences and then identify a region conserved across orthologous sequences. Alignment algorithms, such as Klestahl, Thompson et al., 1994, Lagan, Brudno et al., 2003, Avid, Bray et al., 2003, and Bayes block aligner, Ju et al., 1998, have proven useful for phylogenetic footprinting, but the short length of the conserved motif compared to the length of the non-conserved background sequence, and their variable position in a promoter hampers the alignment of conserved motifs. Moreover, multiple sequence alignment does not reveal meaningful biological information if the species used for comparison are too closely related. If the species are too distantly related, it is difficult to find an accurate alignment. It requires computational tools that bypass the requirement of sequence alignment completely and have the capabilities to identify short and scattered conserved regions. In cases where multiple alignment algorithms fails, motif-finding algorithms such as MIME, consensus and GIP sampler have been used, figure 2. The feasibility of using comparative DNA sequence analysis to identify functional sequences in the genome of S. cerevisiae, with the goal of identifying regulatory sequences and sequences specifying non-protein coding RNAs was investigated, Clifton et al., 2001. It was found that most of the DNA sequences of the closely related Saccharomyces species aligned to S. cerevisiae sequences and known promoter regions were conserved in the alignments. Pattern search algorithms like consensus, Hertz et al., 1990, GIP sampling, Lawrence et al., 1993, and Align ACE, Roth et al., 1998, were useful for identifying known regulatory sequence elements in the promoters, where they are conserved through the most diverged Saccharomyces species. GIP sampler was used for motif finding using phylogenetic footprinting in proteobacterial genomes, McHugh et al., 2001. These programs employ two approaches for motif finding. One approach is to employ a training set of transcription factor binding sites and a scoring scheme to evaluate predictions. The scoring scheme is often based on information theory, and the training set is used to empirically determine a score threshold for reporting of the predicted transcription factor binding sites. The second method relies on a rigorous statistical analysis of the predictions, based upon modeled assumptions. The statistical significance of a sequence matched to a motif can be accessed through the determination of p-value. P-value is the probability of observing a match with a score as good or better in a randomly generated search space of identical size and nucleotide composition. The smaller the p-value, the lesser the probability that the match is due to chance alone. Since the motif-finding algorithms assume the input sequences to be independent, therefore, they are limited by the fact that the datasets containing a mixture of some closely related species will have an unduly high weight in the results of motifs reported. Multiple genome sequences were compared that are as optimally diverged as possible in Saccharomyces genomes. Phylogenetic footprints were searched among the genome sequences of 6 Saccharomyces species using the sequence alignment tool Klestahl W and many statistically significant conserved sequence motifs, Clifton et al., 2003, were found. Combined block diagram of NMEME output highlighting conserved motifs in promoter regions of legumin seed storage protein genes of 4 different species. This promising novel algorithm was developed to overcome the limitations imposed by motif-finding algorithms. This algorithm identifies the most conserved motifs among the input sequences as measured by a parsimony score on the underlying phylogenetic tree, Blanchett and Tampa, 2002. It uses dynamic programming to find most parsimonious k-mer from each of the input sequences where k is the motif length. In general, the algorithm selects motifs that are characterized by a minimal number of mismatches and are conserved over long evolutionary distances. Furthermore, the motif should not have undergone independent losses in multiple branches. In other words, the motif should be present in the sequences of subsequent taxa along a branch. The algorithm, based on dynamic programming, proceeds from the leaves of the phylogenetic tree to its root and seeks for motifs of a user-defined length with a minimum number of mismatches. Moreover, the algorithm allows a higher number of mismatches for those sequences that span a greater evolutionary distance. Motifs that are lost along a branch of the tree are assigned an additional cost because it is assumed that multiple independent losses are unlikely in evolution. To compensate for spurious hits, statistical significance is calculated based on a random set of sequences in which no motifs occur. CONREAL, Conserved Regulatory Elements Anchored Alignment Algorithm, is another motif-finding algorithm based on phylogenetic footprinting, Berezikov et al., 2005. This algorithm uses potential motifs as represented by positional weight matrices, 81 vertebrate matrices from Jasper database and 546 matrices from TransFact database, to establish anchors between orthologous sequences and to guide promoter sequence alignment. Comparison of the performance of CONREAL with the global alignment programs LAGAN and AVID using a reference data set, shows that CONREAL performs equally well for closely related species like rodents and human, and has a clear added value for aligning promoter elements of more divergent species like human and fish, as it identifies conserved transcription factor binding sites that are not found by other methods. The FELINIT computational approach identifies conserved regulatory motifs directly from whole genome sequences of related species without reliance on additional information was developed by Wang and Stormo, 2005. The major steps involved are, I. construction of phylogenetic profiles for each promoter, 2. searching through the entire profile space of all the promoters in the genome to identify conserved motifs and the promoters that contain them using algorithm-like BLAST, 3. Determination of statistical significance of motifs, Carlin and Alchel, 1990. By comparing promoters using phylogenetic profiles, multiple sequence alignments of orthologous promoters, rather than individual sequences, together with the application of modified Carlin-Alchel statistics, they readily distinguished biologically relevant motifs from background noise. When applied to 3,524 Saccharomyces cerevisiae promoters with Saccharomyces macaidi, Saccharomyces cudriavzevia, and Saccharomyces bionu sequences as references, FELINIT identified 296 statistically significant motifs with a sensitivity of greater than 90% for known transcription factor binding sites. The specificity of the predictions appears very high because most predicted gene clusters have additional supporting evidence, such as enrichment for a specific function, in vivo binding by a known TF, or similar expression patterns. However, the prediction of additional transcription factor binding sites by comparison of a motif to the promoter regions of an entire genome has its own problems due to the large database size and the relatively small width of a typical transcription factor binding site. There is an increased chance of identification of many sites that match the motif, and the variability among the transcription factor binding sites permits differences in the level of regulation, due to the altered intrinsic affinities for the transcription factor, Carmack et al., 2007. PhyloScan combines evidence from matching sites found in orthologous data from several related species with evidence from multiple sites within an intergenic region. The orthologous sequence data may be multiply-aligned, unaligned, or a combination of aligned and unaligned. In aligned data, PhyloScan statistically accounts for the phylogenetic dependence of the species contributing data to the alignment and, in unaligned data, the evidence for sites is combined assuming phylogenetic independence of the species. The statistical significance of the gene predictions is calculated directly, without employing training sets, Carmack et al., 2007. The application of the algorithm to real sequence data from 7 Enterobacteriales species identifies novel CRP and PER transcription factor binding sites, thus providing several new potential sites for these transcription factors.